my dear friends, in the previous videos, we have covered individually about the photosynthesis, light dependent and light independent reactions. In this video, we are going to cover the whole process at once, and we have to attain the summary of what is light reaction and what is dark reaction. The combination of light reaction and dark reaction, we call it as photosynthesis. How does it happen and what are the things are needed and what is the output? Okay, so initially we have to know the nutrition level, autotrophs and heterotrophs. Autotrophs will prepare their own food, for example, plants, blue-green algae and some prokaryotes. So these are called as producers. Heterotrophs will be dependent on their food on other organisms. So hetero means different, so on other organisms. Examples are animals, fungus and some prokaryotes and protists. So these are also called it as consumers. So these will consume the food from other organisms. So let's see the main part of the topic, photosynthesis. What is a photosynthesis? Is a process by which the plants and some other organisms uses the light energy to convert water and carbon dioxide into oxygen and carbohydrates such as glucose. So in the next slide, we are going to see the reaction takes place inside the chloroplast. Photosynthesis is essentially the only mechanism of energy input into the living world. Coming to the inputs and outputs, what are the ingredients are needed here is light, water and carbon dioxide. The combination of water and carbon dioxide will give carbohydrate and oxygen. So the giving of and products are nothing but sugar, which are nothing but carbohydrates and oxygen. Okay, so the next part, formula for the photosynthesis. It is a very easy formula. So 6CO2 plus 6H2O gives rise to C6H12. So 6 into 2 is equal to 12, H12 and O6 plus 6O2. So these are the 6O2. So this is the 6O2. So carbon dioxide plus water gives rise to sugar plus oxygen. The major steps in photosynthesis are, first, initially we needed light dependent reaction. So we can call it as light reaction because light is essential. And the next thing is light independent reactions, which we also call it as dark reactions. I am making it very simple that we will call in the next slides also as light reaction and dark reaction to avoid the confusion between the lengthiest words. So we need light reaction. So the first happened reaction is light reaction. And the next reaction, preceding reaction is dark reaction. Dark reaction will use the products of light reaction. So from the products of light reaction means ATP and NADPH. So both reactions will occur simultaneously, one after the other. So this is the major steps of photosynthesis. Nothing but light reaction plus dark reaction is equal to photosynthesis. So let's see. And one more thing, where is the light reaction will happen? Light reaction will happen inside the chloroplast. Okay, both dark reaction also inside the chloroplast, but the light reaction will happen on the thylakoid membrane and the dark reaction will happen in the stroma. Okay, let's see what is the thylakoid and what is the stroma. Coming to the light reactions, initially we have to know about the structure of this chlorophyll. So chloroplast. So plastids are the thing. So we have different types of plastids based on the storage, based on the color. So now we are going to see the plastids based on the color. So if the plastids having the chlorophyll, we call it as chloroplast. So which is green in color. Why it is green in color means because it reflects the green light. On this basis, we call it as chlorophyll. Chloro means green. So chloroplast. So what is the structure of chloroplast? Where does this chloroplast are present? The chloroplast is present overall the body of the plant, except on the roots, we cannot find the chloroplast. So because of this, it is white in color or brown in color. In the leaves, you will have a mesophyll cells. Inside that mesophyll cells, we will have huge number of chloroplast. So inside that chloroplast, the chloroplast are present inside the cell as a double membrane bounded cell organelle. The chloroplast also will have their own DNA and their own ribosomes. Okay, so let's see. So this is the outer envelope. So this is like a oval plastid, so which is been enclosed by a double membrane, outer envelope and inner envelope. The space between the outer envelope and inner envelope, we call it as intermembrane space. And we have a coin-like structures. And one coin, we call it as thylakoid. Likewise, we have many coins arranged in a form of stack. So this all together, we call it as granum. Okay. And the space, we call it as stroma. So from one granum to another granum, we have a connection. So, which we call it as stroma lamella. And from granum to inner envelope connection, we call it as grana lamella. Okay. So, this is all about the chloroplast. And here we have a cross section of granum. So, this whole thing is granum. So, this one is thylakoid. So, if you cut the thylakoid, you can see inside a space, lumen, and this membrane. This is the thylakoid membrane. On this membrane only, we have the chlorophyll, which is a pigment, green color pigment, because it reflects the green light. Because of that, it is green in color. But what the light will absorb is red and blue. Only during photosynthesis, the absorption of light is red and blue, and the reflection of the light is green. So, what does the light reaction takes place? So, what is light reaction means? It involves the excitation of chlorophyll. For the excitation, we need high amount of energy. That energy is being given by sunlight. Takes place inside the chloroplast on the thylakoid membrane. Here, the light reaction will take place on this membrane. And next, thylakoids are nothing but a sac-like photosynthetic membranes, grana stacks of the thylakoid stroma. So, regions outside the thylakoid membrane. So, the regions outside the thylakoid, we call it a stroma. And this is the grana. And this is thylakoid. This, they are explaining about the thylakoid, grana and stroma. And next, light absorption in the chloroplast. How this light absorption will take place? The chloroplast in the plant cells absorb the light energy from the sun during the light dependent reactions only. Whenever during the dark reaction, there is no need of light. Only during light reactions. So, photosynthetic cells may have thousands of chloroplasts. The chlorophyll and the accessory pigments such as carotenoids functions to absorb the light. So, the light capturing pigment in the grana are organized in a form of photosystems. These photosystems are nothing but chlorophyll pigments. So, we can able to see here. So, what as we discussed priorly, red and blue lights are absorbed at high level. So, we can see from this picture very easily. We have many types of pigments, chlorophyll A, chlorophyll B and carotenoids. Here, you can see the highest peaks at blue light and at red light. At 700 and at 680. So, at this picture, you can see the red as well as, blue as well as the red light. So, these are the two lights are being absorbed more by chlorophyll. And it reflects the green light. So, here we can see. So, this and the spectrum also is going to tell us about the red and blue light is going to absorb at higher spectrum. And this is the picture is clear that we have the VibGR. In this VibGR, blue and red light is being absorbed and green is reflected. Because of that, the leaf will look green in color. So, energy transfer, electron transfer, energy transfer and electron transfer. Initially, we need energy. Energy is coming from sunlight. Sunlight will hit the chloroplast. Inside the chloroplast, we have grana. On the grana, we have thylakoid. On the thylakoid, we have chlorophyll pigments. So, the pigments are being arranged in a form of antenna complex. So, or we also call photosystems. So, we have many photosystems. So, photosystem, we have the two, photosystem 1 and photosystem 2. So, the pigment, so the energy will hit this pigment molecules. All are being arranged in a form of an antenna complex. From here, it will go to reaction center. So, the reaction center will receive the electrons and this electrons is being transported to the acceptor. Okay. So, the electrons is being given by water. So, water will be splitted to form. So, to give the electrons to the reaction center from here, the electrons will be transported and finally given to NAD+. So, let's see what happens in the next. So, the light dependent reaction or light reaction. The main function of the light reaction is to generate NADPH and ATP, which is being used by dark reaction. So, these are the two ingredients has to be prepared by light reaction required for carbon reduction. So, carbon reduction will take place in dark reaction. So, NADPH and ATP is generated through a series of reactions that constitute the photosynthetic electron transport chain. So, through this electron transport chain only, it takes place. So, water is being split and given off the oxygen and electrons. Let's see how it happens. Light is absorbed by chlorophyll A, which excites the electrons in the chlorophyll molecule. electrons from the split water is passed through a series of carriers along the electron transport chain and the ATP is released. Some hydrogen from the split water is used to reduce the NADP, nothing but nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide phosphate, to NADPH. Reduced nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide phosphate. And next, ATP and NADPH, what are their importance? ATP and NADPH, which will store the energy in their bonds. So, this energy is being used for the reduction of carbon dioxide to sugars. Okay, so these ATP and NADPH are produced from light reactions. ATP loses a phosphate to become ADP, releasing energy. So, NADPH loses a hydrogen to form NAD plus, releasing energy. So, these bonds will be splitting to release the energy. ATP will split to ADP plus PI and gives the energy. NADPH will split to NAD plus plus H plus plus H plus. That H plus is used for the reduction of carbon dioxide. And photosynthetic electron transport chain, how it works. So, priorly, this is the grana membrane. Sorry, this is the thylakoid membrane. So, on this thylakoid membrane, we have photosystem 2. First, you will have the photosystem 2. Next, only you will have the photosystem 1. So, this is photosystem 2 and photosystem 1. In center, we have a protein complex, which we call it as cytochrome B6F complex. So, initially, the light is going to hit the photosystem 2. Okay. Here we have the chlorophyll. So, the chlorophyll molecules will get excited. Immediately, the water, the 2H2O will split to 4H plus plus O2. So, from here, two electrons are being transferred to chlorophyll. From the chlorophyll to plastoquinone. From the plastoquinone. So, these are the mobile transporters. From the plastoquinone to cytochrome B6F. So, from the cytochrome B6F to plastocyanin. From the plastocyanin to chlorophyll. So, this chlorophyll, this is photosystem 1. It will go to photosystem 1. From here, so finally, these electrons are being used for carbon dioxide, reduction of carbon dioxide to form the sugars, carboxylation. So, this is the whole summary of the process of photosynthesis electron transport chain, nothing but how the electrons are transported from light to photosystem 2 to cytochrome B6F complex to photosystem 1 and finally for carboxylation. Okay. Let's see the next part. The overall effect of electron transport chain is to extract a low energy electrons from the water and using the light energy trapped by the chlorophyll to increase their energy level to finally to produce a strong reductant, nothing but NADPH. From here, it is being produced NADPH. And again, this is one more clear picture about the light reaction. So the light is going to hit to photosystem 2. Here it is the energy of wavelength is P680. So this amount of wavelength is being absorbed by this PS2. So when the PS2 electrons are chlorophyll is being excited, the water will split to oxygen and H plus ions. From here, the 4 electrons is being transported to plastoquinone. From the plastoquinone, so it is being transported to B6F. And from here, the hydrogen ions is also being transported to here. So, these hydrogen ions is being transported at here. So, from plastocyanin to PS1. From here to here, we are talking about only about the electrons. So, some of the hydrogen will come from plastoquinone to inside. So, this red will tell us about the hydrogen ions. Here inside also, we have the numerous hydrogen ions. From here also, it is being transported some of the hydrogen ions. Okay, this is about hydrogen. And electrons will get transported from PS2 to plastoquinone to cytochrome B6F, cytochrome B6F to plastocyanin to PS2, photosystem 2. And from here again, the sunlight will hit with a wavelength of P700. From here, through ferredoxin, it will go to ferredoxin NADP reductase with this enzyme. It will convert the NADP by adding the hydrogen ion to form NADPH. Okay. So, and we have the huge concept. Here the NADPH is produced. And next we need ATP. Here we have the huge concentration of hydrogen ions. So the hydrogen ions will move from a higher concentration to lower concentration. So it will move through this ATP synthase. This protein complex we call it as ATP synthase. From here to here it will move. So moving from the higher concentration to the lower concentration, so this energy is being used to fuse the ADP plus PI to form ATP. So finally, NADPH plus ATP, these two ingredients are being formed in light reaction, which is being used by dark reaction. So let's see about, so again this is the picture will tells us about, so let's see about the theory part. Electrons are picked up by plastoquinone. So if you have understood the previous slide, whatever the theory here, it will be very easy for you. Electrons are picked up by plastoquinone, which also picks up the hydrogen ions from the stroma. Yes, so we have seen here, electrons are picked up by plastoquinone and also the hydrogen ions are picked up from the stroma, and it is given to inside this lumen of the thylakoid. So which picks up and moves the electron to cytochrome B6F while moving the hydrogen ions into the lumen. Next, the plastocyanin moves the electrons to PS1. Using the energy from the light, this electron is moved to pyridoxine complex where it combines with NAD plus NAD and H to form NADPH. So the plastocyanin moves the electron to PS1 using the energy from the light. This electron is moved to pyridoxine complex where it combines with NADP and H plus to form NADPH. So phosphorylation, nothing but light-driven phosphorylation or ATP synthesis. ATP is synthesized in CF0 and CF1 complex, which contains ATP synthase located at end of each electron transport chain complex. This is ATP synthase. So with proton gradient, nothing but from higher concentration to lower concentration, higher concentration in the lumen when compared to the stroma. So with this movement, the energy is created. That energy is being used by ATP plus PA to form ATP. ADP plus PA to form ATP. So this is the picture. This is the pictorial representation again. Initially, we have the low energy electrons. So the low energy electrons is converted to high energy electrons. So for example, 4 photons are being absorbed with a wavelength of 680. Now the 4 electrons is being coming from water molecules, splitting of the water molecules. So now this 4 electrons are transported to pheophyton to plastoquinone, plastoquinone to cytochrome complex. So here the ATP is produced via proton motive force, nothing but the plastoquinone will bring some of the protons from the stroma into the lumen. Okay, from here to plastocyanin to, from cytochrome B6F to plastocyanin, from the plastocyanin to P700, which is photosystem 1, from the photosystem 1 to, so these 4 electrons will go to pyridoxine. So next pyridoxine reductase, which will make the NAD plus plus 2H plus 2 to NADPH. So 2 NADPH is produced from this light reaction, as well as the ATP also. And next, at the end of the light dependent reactions, we have ATP and NADPH, and oxygen is given off. So oxygen will comes from water. And next, light independent reaction, nothing but we also call it as Kelvin cycle. So which uses the ATP and NADPH from light reaction. So the dark reaction uses it. So we also call it as C3 cycle or carbon reduction cycle. All the 3 names are for this dark reaction. And fixation of carbon dioxide by Kelvin cycle using the ATP and NADPH from the light reaction occurs only in 3 steps. One is carboxylation, other one is reduction, and finally regeneration. Carboxylation of carbon dioxide. So this carboxylation of carbon dioxide to ribulose 1,5 bisphosphate and forming of, so carboxylation means adding of carbon. So here the carbon is added to ribulose 1,5 bisphosphate to form 2 molecules of 3-PGA, nothing but 3-phosphoglycerate. And next, from here, the reduction will take place. So the reduction is from NADPH is being reduced as NAD plus plus H plus ions. So the hydrogen ions is from this NADPH, the hydrogen is added to this. So finally it's been converted. So for 3-phosphoglycerate, the hydrogen is being added, nothing but reduction is being taking place, and now it is converted to glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. So which is nothing but a sucrose or starch. Finally it is converted to sucrose or starch, and again we have the reduction, regeneration phase, nothing but conversion of again back to ribulose 1,5-bisphosphate. So carboxylation, adding of carbon to RUBP, and next, so with the form, and after adding of carbon it is converted to 3-PGA, and now this 3-PGA is reduced. For the reduction we need hydrogen, that hydrogen is being supplied by this NADPH. Now it is forming glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, which in turn converted to sucrose or starch, and finally the regeneration takes place again back to RUBP. So for this regeneration we need ATP. So the two products from the light reaction is used here in the Kelvin cycle, and the starch is being produced. Oxygen is from water. So this is one more picture about this Kelvin cycle. There are several steps in the Kelvin cycle that requires the enzymes. The most important enzyme in the Kelvin cycle is ribulose 1,5-bisphosphate, carboxylate and oxalase. We also call it as Rubisco. So Rubisco catalyzes the first reaction in the Kelvin cycle. So coming to the importance of Kelvin cycle, glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate can be converted to many other molecules. Like glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate can be converted to glucose phosphate, fatty acid synthesis and amino acid synthesis. From the glucose, fructose phosphate, from the fructose phosphate to, so glucose phosphate plus fructose phosphate gives rise to sucrose. And from here, the glucose phosphate is converted to starch and cellulose. So it will be converted to many compounds. So the hydrocarbon skeleton of G3P can form fatty acids and glycerol to make plant oils. Glucose phosphate for simple sugars, fructose, which with glucose sucrose, starch and cellulose as well as amino acids. So this, the picture will tell us about the overall what is going to happen. So once again, photosynthesis. We are going to summarize very easily photosynthesis. So photosynthesis will happen in chloroplast. So inside the chloroplast also, we have the two reactions, light reaction and dark reaction. Light reaction. In the light reaction will take place on granum. So granum on the thylakoid membrane. So light reaction is nothing but, so usage of light energy for the production of NADPH and ATP, which are the final products in the light reaction. So these products are used by dark reaction, nothing but for carbon cycle, C3 cycle. So for the C3 cycle, we have the carboxylation, reduction and regeneration. So finally, the starch, glucose or fatty acids, amino acids is being produced from this photosynthesis. So this is the overall summary of the photosynthesis. So thank you guys. Thank you very much for watching the video. Please do subscribe to my channel for more biology videos. Thank you.